Anonymous says, what do you think of alternative testing like hair mineral analysis or SpectraCell? I'm against SpectraCell on the basis that it's not validated. I gave more details in a podcast episode, what makes a good marker of nutritional status. And you can find that at chrismasterjohnphd.com/marker. And hair mineral analysis, I like hair mineral analysis when there's nothing better and more validated. And so for a lot of the trace minerals where we don't have good validated markers of nutritional status, I think hair mineral analysis is good. And I think hair mineral analysis is also good if you don't have the money to do something comprehensive with all the best markers and you want something that can clue you in when something might be off. So the nice thing about it is with less money, you cover all the minerals. The less nice thing about it is it's not very well validated quantitatively. Like even where there's data, like for example, it is validated that your iron in your hair tends to be higher when your iron in your body is higher and vice versa. But it's not validated to say when hair is X amount, this is when you need more iron. And when hair is Y amount, this is when you need less. The way that the blood markers are, like transferrin saturation, ferritin, hemoglobin, all these more validated markers, we have tons of quantitative data saying like the normal range is this, the optimal range is this. And so you lose the precision when you go back to the hair mineral analysis. So I wouldn't use it. The thing is, if you spend $200 on a hair mineral analysis, that's $200 that you can't put towards your Genova ion panel, or $200, like you could have gotten 4 iron panels with that, right? So you have to be careful that if your financial resources are constrained, you might want to do the hair mineral analysis on that basis, but it might be a better financial decision long-term to hold on to that money and do free stuff. And, you know, testing nutritional status, the ultimate cheat sheet, what I say is if you don't have the money for the comprehensive testing, you focus on the things that are free. You do the dietary and lifestyle analysis. You do the symptom analysis. And then you go to the things that indicates is most probable. And then you do the best validated tests. Like maybe this diet and symptom analysis all points you to iron and you spend $60 on an iron panel and that gives you more payoff than $200 on a hair mineral analysis. So it's not an obvious choice about when to get the suboptimal test, but it's something you have to think about carefully.